diameter of how much mm? With a diameter of 50 mm. Okay. Once you have marked the circle, mark the diameters. Okay. Mark the horizontal and vertical diameters. So we'll mark the vertical and horizontal diameters here. So these are the vertical and horizontal diameters. Start with long dash, end with long dash. Okay. Again, one thing is that your point is starting from here. Okay. See carefully. Your point is starting from horizontal diameter at your left hand. Okay, so point is here, point P is here. Okay, now divide the circle into 12 parts, not 8 parts. Each and every time you need to divide the circle now into 12 parts. So I will divide the circle into 12 parts. Okay, so I will make the divisions, 12 divisions. So totally I have made here 12 divisions. We will make these 12 divisions. Okay, and your numbering should be in anti-clockwise direction. Your numbering should be anti-clockwise. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 is here right now. But what is our concept? Our point is starting from this position and again it comes to the original position. So no need to write the 12 number here. Okay, so point P is starting from here and it again comes to same point. Okay, so give the dimension for this circle. So dimension is always denoted with the symbol 5 and 550 is here. Okay, so we have considered this helix as a cylinder, so we are drawing the circle. Now I want to draw the rectangle in your front view. So I will take all the projections. I will, for a moment I will draw here the front line. And I will take all the projections in upward direction. So these are the projections in upward direction. The center also. And we know that the axis height or height of this cylinder is 100 mm. Okay. So I will make this 100 mm. At this 100 mm height, I will make a rectangle. Okay. So this is the rectangle. At a height of 100 mm. I will make some big rectangle here. So this is the rectangle. Now divide this rectangle. See here. Now divide this rectangle again into 12 parts. Divide this rectangle, that means the vertical edge of this rectangle into 12 parts. Okay, so this height is how much? This is 100 mm right now. So I want to make that 12 parts. So how much mm? Each segment is how much mm? Okay. Yes? 8 point something, right now. But we want to divide this line into equal parts. For that, I will make an angle. This I will make an angle and I will make the 12 divisions on this angle. Angular line or this inclined line. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10, 11 and the last one is 12 divisions. Okay, now join the last point and this last point of inclination, line of inclination. So I will this join this line and this line and now make this parallelize through each and every point and project it on this vertical line. So I will make all these lines parallel and project 1, 2, 3. 4, 5. Okay. So I have made the all divisions here. That is the 12th line cross to the 11. Okay. So this is P11. This is P11. Similarly, I will take a projection for 2 and 10 because it is on same line. So I will take a projection of 2 and 12. 2 and 10. So this is a point 2 and this point is 10. So P10, P2. Okay. So this is a 3 and 9. So we are getting 3 is here, P3 and P9. This is a 4 and 8. So I will make a 4 and 8. So this point is 4, P4 and P8. This is a 5 and 7. So I will take a 5 and 7 in upward direction. So this is a P5. And this is P7. Now this is the projection of P6. So P6 is here. Right now P6 is here. Now I want to join all the points. So I will join all the points here. Okay. So point is starting from P and goes to the P. So I will join all these points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Up to 6, this line is the dark line. Okay. And after this, the curve is starting here. These lines are dashed line. These lines are dashed line, and you are getting this curve. And this curve is called helix. This is helix. This is helix. Okay, so in this way we have completed our helix. Simple helix. Okay.